Hey folks, this is Custom Chess for Roma Custom Bike and I welcome you to part 2 of the third episode of the series about the Triumph Speed Triple Base Custom Bike. In the first episode of this series, we took care of demolition and we rebuilt the tail end out of sheet metal. In the second episode, we took a look at how to design and build some new parts for this project using CAD software and a CNC machine. In this two-part episode, the third of the series, we are taking a look at the Arduino-based electronics that we'll need to power the new accessories. And last but not least, in the fourth episode, we'll take care of the paint job, assembly and unveiling to the owner of the bike. So, be sure to stay tuned, subscribe to the channel and follow the links in the description to find all the episodes in this series. Now, let's get back to the next challenge, waterproofing. Like every accessory we install on our beloved bikes, we have to make sure we don't fry everything at the first downpour we cross on the road. After a bit of googling, I found that one possible option is to use what is called a conformal coating, some kind of spray plastic that is also used to insulate transformer windings. I really wanted to make sure this would be a suitable solution, especially for this bike, since I'm not the one that is gonna be driving it day by day. So, I figured I'd run some tests and prove that my stuff was ready to face even a Florida-style hurricane. Yeah! I made two little boards, each one with an LED light, and I sprayed the conformal coating only on the one with the green light, so that I could use the red one as a control for the experiment. Very mythbustery of me, ha! I used the bottom battery as power supply and began right away with the untreated board. The light did not turn off, also because the amount of current was minimal. But you can immediately see the chemical reaction in the form of what seems to be some white smoke. It is the precipitation of the minerals contained in the tap water, triggered by the electricity being in direct contact with the water. Now I try with the green board, the one treated with the waterproofing product. We can observe a minimal amount of precipitation, and after further analysis, I figured it originates from the front side of the board that was not treated. Even then, the difference is impressive. The conformal coating seems to work great. This is an extreme situation as well. If the same exposure should occur in real life, it would mean that I would be in an actual tsunami and I probably would have much more serious problems than a short in the lighting system. So, let's proceed with coating all my components with the spray on both the solder side as well as the component side. I'll let them dry before getting to the installation on the bike. Now, I would like to remind you guys that this channel exists because of you and your support. We're going to keep posting videos in English on this channel for the next few months, but we're also separating the Italian channel from the English one because YouTube is not yet really equipped to tailor all the needs of a multi-language channel such as ours. So, in the next few months, we'll be moving the English videos to the new channel called Custom Bike. I invite all of you guys to subscribe to it by clicking right here, here, here somewhere, or the link in the description. Please help us out by sharing the new channel and the videos on your social network. Thank you very much, and let's get back to work. Before sealing everything up and getting to the powder coating, I want to make sure every single piece I've created works properly. Lab tests are certainly useful, but nothing beats the real thing. Testing right on the bike. I start by connecting the main brain to the signals coming from the original turn signal lines. It does look like a mess, but it really isn't. It's important though to use color coding and labels to avoid messing things up and finding ourselves in a wire nightmare. Wow, it sounds like a TV show! Wire Nightmares with Gordon Ramsay! Using my soldering pen and heat shrink sleeves, I connect all the wires to the main brain one by one, To be precise, we have 20 independent LEDs for the turn signals, 5 per side for front and back, 16 LEDs for the stoplight, and 12 for the front marker lights. Bottom line, a lot of freaking connections, but in the end, everything seems to work properly. The new lithium battery also needs to be connected, and even with its reduced size compared to the lead equivalent, still fits pretty snug in the space we have left for it. But you know, if it was so easy, everybody would be doing it, right? Now we can hook up the computer to the Arduino USB plug so that we can monitor the process from the serial communication port and eventually do final adjustments on the code. Let's proceed with the very first total function test on the bike. There is a bit of overlapping of the lights when switching from one side to the other, due to the delay needed to properly convert the intermittent signal coming from the original turning system. But in real life, it shouldn't be much of an issue. The front light seems to work properly as well as the turn signal. Very well, let's do the final detailing and powder coating. As you can see, the CNC machining, especially with a non-professional machine like mine, creates a not-so-perfect finish, so I need to clean that up by hand or it will show through the paint in the finished project. So, while Polsky Rage is working on his super mega modified Sportster tank for his Softail that will be part of the next series of episodes, I will work each piece by hand for a nice and smooth finish. By now you guys should know about powder coating, but in case you don't, please check out the 5 or 6 videos I've done on the subject. Anyway, this is the results, and to me, it looks awesome! The texturized paint is the same I've used on my bike, and combined with the brass inserts, I have to say, it looks fantastic! For the taillight, it got a bit trickier. The powder paint is quite thick, so I had to mask all the surfaces that will have to go in contact with each other, so not to modify the geometry of the part once assembled. This was done with high temperature tape. It kept the surfaces clean from the paint, and since it's aluminum, we don't have to worry about rust. Once the two halves have been assembled, it looks like a single piece of aluminum. Very nice. I'm almost done. I installed the plate holder and then it's time to assemble the LED boards. The red and blue wires will fit the plate light. I'm using a standard aftermarket light model, like the ones you see on a lot of speed bikes. The second LED board is installed. The two parts can be put together and I'm starting to be impatient. The brass plate is now polished to a mirror shine, and with a little bit of manhandling, it fits over the LEDs. 4 screws are required to keep it in place, and there you go. The taillight is complete, and I think it's really kick-ass. All the temporary connections have been cleaned up with some waterproof plugs. The taillight has been installed on the bike, and the main brain has found a home under the gas tank inside a plastic bag that will keep it protected from moisture and dirt. The original instrument cluster will also be placed here under the tank. We found out that these clusters are coded and the bike will not start without it. So, since we decided to go for a minimal aftermarket instrument cluster, the original one has to be stored here. I might do a video on the subject since I haven't found much about it on the web, but let's stay focused on our goal right now, the lights. Finally, the first test. The stoplight is working, so are the turn signal. You can hear the original relay clicking away independently from our system, showing you that this is a real plug and play product. Feel the sunshine. The front works too, both the marker lights and the signals. I want to thank Sergio for working long and hard at the code for this project, and don't miss the next episode because we'll be painting and assembling the bike and then unveiling it to its owner. Now, don't forget to subscribe to my channel to receive notifications of new published videos. Like, comment, and please share, because that's what helps us grow. Now, if you like, you can visit also our website where you can find all our accessories and our t-shirt. Thank you very much for the support and for watching. I'm Custom Chess for Roma Custom Bike, and I'll see you in the next video. We'll be right back.